We don't have a name yet? Oh, we're gonna have to work on that.
Welcome to week 18 and 19 of the vlog. It's been a while since I've been on site, but we're back at it. Took a little bit of a break there. We're right back into the exciting action. We got Nick today from Corey's Plumbing here, running some new pipe here for a shower and a two-piece a vanity and a toilet, so it's a three-piece in total. Had to trench a bit to get all that new rough-ins for that, and we'll be taking up the remainder of the tile here. And this is the laundry room. That's gonna be the bathroom. We're gonna put a wall across here. Everything's looking really good so far, and pretty much excited to get back to the vlogging action. So we'll be pretty busy this week, and we'll keep you guys updated with an actually good vlog this week instead of all that filler shit the last couple weeks. Because I was a little slower there. Well, not slow by choice, because I knew it's gonna pick up. And this should be kind of week one, because it's just gonna go insane from here, and the videos are just gonna get a lot better and more exciting. So yeah, that's it. So I'll see you guys next clip.
Well, good morning, folks. We're here in Mississauga at the hashtag project question mark.
There's no
name. We don't have a name yet? Oh, we're gonna have to work on that. And we found some of Jack's friends' hiding spot up in here. Maybe we can find a live one to throw at him today and watch Jack go nuts. Looks like we're gonna have to rip all this insulation out. It's probably mouse urine and feces. Yum. Breakfast time.
So we're back here on site. It's Saturday morning. Got my HVAC guy coming in today to hook up my Panasonic fan. And then I got my electrician coming to wire everything, put in some switches, and do some low voltage wire, because we're gonna do some accent pieces here. What we got going on here is we got a pocket door that we framed yesterday. Me and Ty did it. These are LSLs. I don't know if you've ever seen them before. Not many people use them, but the whole point of them is they're pretty expensive, but they're not going to move. They're a lot stronger, and because you're putting the wood on its side, it's going to be a lot weaker. So what I did was I glued every single joint, butt joint, and then after toenailed and screwed all my blocking. So you got a 26 inch pocket that's gonna slide right in to the side here. And then after, we got our traditional framing on this side. And then over here, we put some more LSL blocking for the vanity. It's gonna be a floating vanity. It's gonna be 32 inches up. So that's why we got some blocking here. Gotta make make sure that it's strong enough to hold it. And so you should make sure, if you guys are ever doing a bathroom reno, get your specs on all your vanities, everything like that. Another thing we need blocking for, I gotta do this morning, is there's gonna be a heated towel rack on these marks here. It's gonna curve all the way over, matte black. 450 watt power needs to be ran for this too today, and need to put some blocking in so we can hold up that unit, because it's gonna be pretty heavy. The spray paint here is the shower. It's gonna be pretty big, 72 inches by 36 inches, and the shower head's gonna be up there. And then you got your niche, you got your controls. You're gonna have a sliding glass door here. We'll walk in, turn on your water, and then after you can let it heat up and then walk in. And you got your soaps and then your shower. What else did we do? We got most of the concrete done here. The reason why we left this is we had it set for a 32 inch shower, and then after I discussed with the client to make it a bit bigger because we had some extra room left over in this spot, so we added an extra couple inches. So when Nick comes back on Monday, he's gonna put a coupling on it, move it over a little bit, and then we'll pour it together and then put down some Schluter. So that's that. And then the toilet's there. He's ran all his plumbing there. I'm gonna put one more stud here for some blocking after, but this whole shower is gonna be, or the whole bathroom, I should say, is gonna be tiled completely. It's gonna be subway tiles on the walls, hexagon mosaic on the ceiling, hexagon mosaic in the bathroom shower. And then after, it's gonna be a traditional 8 inch by 8 inch square porcelain tile on the floor to give us some rustic, or not rustic, I'd say more of a traditional feel, black and white bathroom. So that's pretty much it here. Got some of the doors removed because we're doing all the doors and all the trim in the whole house. And that's pretty much it. So I gotta get framing here because this wall is out here. I'll show you guys. So I check all my walls before I frame, before I tile and stuff like that, because if they're not square, or they're not plumb, I should say, you know, you're gonna have troubles. So this is what it's at here. It's not off by much, but that's enough to screw me up. And nothing but perfection here. So that's not good enough. So we're gonna fix all that. And the client was really happy that I went with LSL studs here to make, like, look at that glue. That's the hack fix right there for you. It is just so strong. Like, this thing won't move at all. And like, the test is, we redid up here too, because this was all steel stud framing. But you can now do chin-ups off this thing. This thing's not moving anything. And I made sure it's strong enough to hold all the tiles and everything. So that's it for this week, pretty much. I might do a couple more clips with Paulo, my electrician, and Dan, the HVAC guy. Maybe see what they're doing. And yeah, so that's it for now. I better get back to work, and I'll see you guys soon. So that's it for this week. We got all the electrical roughed in here. We got our 5-gang and then the heated floor thermostat. So we got our towel rack heater, your fan, the strip lighting underneath the ceiling corner. And then we got our wall sconce and then our pot lights. So we got our 3 pot lights, one there in the shower. Then we got another one right over the toilet. And then this light here is just going to be loose here until we get our mirror light, because it's going to get hardwired. And then you got your towel rack. The fan got hooked up too, so we got power for that. And then after, foamed up in there, so this goes directly outside. I'll go show you guys that now. So we went with the black duct here. This is for the ceiling fan, or exhaust fan, I should say. The only thing I gotta do is I gotta get some black caulking for the sides here, and then I'm gonna get some black spray paint to paint the blue tap cons black, because they don't sell them in black, but just to clean it up. Even though, to be honest, no one's gonna come back in this area because the main area is over here, I still want to make sure it looks 100%, so I'm gonna just get some spray paint or nail polish or something like that to cover up that blue, to make it look 100%, and the client's happy, I'm happy. And that's it for this week, so we'll be back next week for another exciting one. Gonna be laying all the heated floors for the whole basement, and that's pretty much it. So I gotta get home and editing this, and then tomorrow I'm back at it again with some more paperwork. So I hope you guys had a good work week, or whatever you guys did, but I'll see you guys later. Thanks.